In Germany, a treasure trove of art believed to have been stolen by the Nazis over 70 years ago has been uncovered in a Munich apartment. And more than 1,400 paintings were found during a 2011 tax raid, but their existence has only now come to light. For more, senior international correspondent Jim Bittermann joins me now live from Munich. And Jim, you are right outside that apartment. Could you walk us through what was found there?
Well, we don't actually know, Christy, all of what was found here. They haven't released a complete list yet of all the works of art. More than 1,400 works of art, as you mentioned, found in this apartment building behind me, in the home of Cornelius Gurlitt, an 80-year-old sort of reclusive type who was the son of Hildebrand Gurlitt, who worked for the Nazis in World War II. He had first not been on the outs with the Nazis because he had a Jewish grandmother. He was fired from his post with the state museums under the Nazis, and then later on, as the Nazis needed money, he was brought back into play trying to sell some of these works of arts overseas. How these works of art then evolved and came down to his son is not entirely clear. There are 1,400 very well-known masters, among them Pablo Picasso, Toulouse-Lautrec, Henri Matisse, and Albrecht Dürer from the 16th century. Some of these may have been seized by the Nazis as degenerate art. Some of them may have been in the possession of Mr. Gurlitt legitimately, as it were. Certainly, if legitimate inheritors can be found, the Germans will return the paintings to them. But at the moment, they're still trying to track down exactly who these do belong to. Christy?
Yeah, you know, in this case, it was discovered in that apartment there in Munich behind you in 2011, but it was only made public this month. So why did it take so long to be made public?
Well, the prosecutor corrected that this morning and said it was 2012, in fact, when they raided the apartment, February of 2012 when they raided the apartment. So that part of the story changed slightly, but still a year and a half, in fact. Then only it's come to light because of the investigative reporting done by government. The prosecutor has not explained that delay. He's also not explained exactly where, in fact, Mr. Gurlitt is. He's 80 years old, and also what he might be charged with, because, in fact, there may not have been anything much illegal here. He basically could be charged with tax evasion because he hasn't paid any taxes on any of the sales of the art. Some of these works were sold over the years, but, in fact, in terms of what the kind of other illegal activity, they're not real sure. So, in fact, we'll see what happens, but the prosecutor has to make.
Yeah, a lot of questions about what legal action could be taken there. Jim Bittermann joining us live from Munich. Thank you very much indeed for that.